Medina, what do you think it does for you individually, for your career? What do you think it does for you?
For me, I think it just shows other people. You know, boxing fans, that's the hardest fans. I think we can all agree to that. Boxing fans are the toughest fans. But I think it just somewhat shows and proves everything that I know and my team knows about me and, you know, the people close to me know. It just kind of shows the world that, you know, I think the world is waiting on, is this kid really what he seems to be? Is this kid what Alan Luis are making him out to be? Is this kid, you know, what he says he is, or is he all hype? Is he just, you know, is he all hype? And I think this fight, as tough as Porky is and the tough test that he's given everyone else, is after this fight, it's going to show people that I'm not hype. So,
David, you have new tattoos since I first saw you on television. Can you tell us what the significance of them are? I'm sure they have
this
beyond
one,
looking.
Yeah,
attractive.
That's for my daughter who passed away January 29th, 2015. It's just, you know, it's a Day of the Dead tattoo, if you, you know, in the Spanish heritage and stuff like that. And it's just, you know, a reminder when I look down who I'm working for and why I go so hard and what I want to accomplish and obtain. And so that's the most important one to me right there.
Caleb, you know, obviously different fighters have different levels of marketability. How would you assess your potential as a star as you continue to win these fights?
Zero if I don't win. You know, and I can be as marketable as I want, but if I don't have these to back it up, then that don't mean shit. You know, to be a superstar, you got to have a great market, but you got to have a great product. And I can have an A-plus market, which I'm sure everyone out here will agree to, but if I don't have an A-plus product, then that don't really mean shit. So at the end of the day, if you can't throw these like you're supposed to, then I can be as good looking as I want, or dress as good as I want, or say all the right words, or make, you know, have all the right dance moves and all this other stuff. But at the end of the day, if you don't get the job done in the ring, then what's marketability in boxing? You know what I'm saying? What does it matter?
But so there's a lot of guys who go undefeated and win titles, but they're never able to get to pay-per-view stardom.
Yeah.
I think you would be able to do
absolutely
that if you keep winning.
Absolutely. If I, you know, God willing, everything just stays how it has been, which, you know, I always hear God blesses those who bless themselves, so that's why I work how I work. Then, yeah, that's exactly what's going to be a pay-per-view superstar. So,
in your amateur days, I understand.